Students, I just hope that you all have purchased your new edition textbook, which is Lakhmir Singh's Science Biology for ICSE from S. Chand Publications. These are the contents of your textbook. These are the chapters that you will be studying for the session. And we started from chapter number 1, The Leaf. We will continue with the same chapter, but before that, I want to give you an important instruction. Students, you all have two practical files, right? So in one practical file, you will be doing all your homework right from 10th homework. So just make sure that you are doing it properly. You are making proper diagrams and you are writing your question answers neatly and in good handwriting. The other practical file is for your practicals. It is actually for your activities and experiments. We'll continue with the same chapter, chapter 1, The Leaf. Now comes the process of photosynthesis. Photo means light, synthesis means putting together. Now what happens in photosynthesis? In photosynthesis, green plants, they prepare their food with the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide, water and minerals from the soil. And what they give out? They give out oxygen. So see the process now. This is sun. These are the sun's energy. This is sunlight. And these are the chlorophylls. Chlorophyll are the pigments that are present in the leaves. And they impart green color to the leaves. And they also help in absorbing sun's energy. So, the leaves, they trap sun's energy and they use carbon dioxide from the air. They use water. And where from water comes? Water is carried into leaves from the soil through the stem. So, it goes here and they take minerals from the soil also. And then they prepare their food. The process of photosynthesis can be written as carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, what they give out? Food in the form of glucose plus oxygen. Now here you can see that oxygen gas is produced in the leaves during photosynthesis. Now this oxygen, it goes into the air. The simplest food prepared by the leaves is glucose. Now some of the glucose is converted into starch, and this starch is stored in food as food in various parts of the plant. In some plants, food is stored in leaves, for example spinach, coriander, etc. And in some plants, food is stored in stem, for example sugarcane, potato, etc. So, photosynthesis can now be defined as the process by which green leaves prepare their food using sunlight, using sun's energy with the help of carbon dioxide and water. And what they release out? Oxygen. Now a plant, they keeps on absorbing water from the soil, and due to this, a lot of water collects in the body of the plant. Now some of the water is used up during the process of photosynthesis, and the extra water which is present in the body of the plant, it is given out constantly in the as water vapor through the tiny pores called stomata of the leaves. Now the evaporation of water, you can see here, the evaporation of water, what is evaporation? The process in which the water changes into water vapor. So the evaporation of water from the leaves of plants is called transpiration. So, during the process of transpiration, what happens? The excess water
present in the plant is lost into the air as water vapor. Now, plants, they release a lot of water vapor into the air through the process of transpiration. And this water vapor, you know, they goes up in the sky and they form clouds. And when these clouds, they become too heavy, they comes down into the earth in the form of rain. So we can say that this water vapor in air helps in bringing rain. Functions of leaf. Now the first function of leaf is the leaves make food for the plant by photosynthesis. So leaves are the food factories of the plant. Then the second is the leaves get rid of excess water from the plant through transpiration. I told you transpiration is a process in which the water, it changes into water vapor and then it goes into the air forming rain. Now the third is the leaves carry out the process of respiration in plants. Now respiration is a process which takes place during the day and the night time. But photosynthesis is a process in which takes place during the daytime only. Why? Because of the presence of sunlight. So you can see here, these are the three functions of leaf. First, it helps in photosynthesis. Second, it loses its excess water through transpiration. And thirdly, they carry out the process of respiration. Respiration, you know, exchange of gases. During the process of respiration, what happens during the daytime? The leaves, they give out oxygen. And in the nighttime, what they give out? Carbon dioxide. So these are the three functions of the leaf. Phyllotaxy. Phyllo means leaf and taxy means arrangement. So arrangement of leaves on stem is called phyllotaxy. Now you can see there are many plants around us and all the plants are different from each other, and the arrangement of leaves on different plants are different. So phyllotaxy, the arrangement of leaves are different in different plants, and there are mainly three types of arrangement. What are they? Alternate, opposite, whorl. See the first one, alternate. Here you can see the plant, the leaf, they are arranged alternately. Here see, alternate manner. Here and the other one is at a distance, then here like this. So this is the alternate phyllotaxy. Now the second is opposite. Here you can see leaf, they are arranged opposite to each other. And here in whorl, whorl means a pattern of concentric circles. Now here they two or more than two leaves, they are arranged in a single node and they form a pattern of circle here like this. So here you can see, so there are three types of phyllotaxy: alternate, opposite and whorl.
This is hibiscus plant, and here you can see leaves are arranged in alternate manner. This is guava leaf, and here you can see leaves are arranged opposite to each other. It's a decorative plant, and here you can see that leaves are arranged at the